How do I transfer data after a clean install of Windows? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's the question. If I install Windows as a clean installation, is there a way to transfer my data without messing up the new installation? Yes, there is. It's just probably not what most people are looking for. Let's talk about what it means to be a clean install first. Remember, a clean install treats the hard disk as if it were empty. It has to work. For example, if your hard disk dies and you need to replace it, by definition, your replacement drive will arrive empty. So a clean install of Windows just starts writing to the hard disk. If the hard disk already has stuff on it, for example, you're doing a clean install, a true clean install, on an existing hard disk that used to have your install of Windows. Same thing. The setup program is going to treat it as an empty disk, and it will probably erase everything that's on that drive. By definition, that's what it means to be a clean install. After you do the clean install, you have nothing on that machine except for Windows itself. So, what does that mean? Well, the secret then to transferring your data is preparation. That can mean any of a number of different techniques. For example, you might copy your data to an external hard drive, or you might do all of your work in folders associated with cloud services like OneDrive or Dropbox or others. That way, the data is automatically uploaded to the cloud, which is unaffected by your clean install. And of course, the other approach, honestly, the approach that I truly recommend, is to back up the entire computer before you do the clean install. Now, of course, if your computer's not working because there's a failure, well, you can't do that. In fact, you can't do any of these things. That's why I say it's all about preparation. And the best way, in my opinion, to prepare is to have a backup happening regularly. I prefer a system image backup because that way you just don't have to think about, do I need to back up this file or these files or those files? Doesn't matter. It backs up everything. In my case, I run a full backup once a month and an incremental every day. So what that means is if my machine were to go belly up right now, at most, I would lose information only from today since that last incremental backup. Now, to be clear, it's actually about more than data. There are other things you should be aware of. Like I said, when you do a clean install, you're erasing everything on the disk. That means, of course, you'll be reinstalling your applications, but one of the things that won't be preserved are any of the customizations and settings that you've made over time. Those you'll have to reapply as well, either before or as part of copying back your data or using the programs in the future. But that's the bottom line. The full process is actually very, very straightforward conceptually. It's just a little time consuming. Step one, back up. If you're not already backing up, be sure to do that. But if you haven't been and your machine is still working, then absolutely create an image backup first. That way you know you'll have all of your files. Step two, clean install Windows. And that will mean erasing the hard disk and getting rid of everything else on that hard disk. That's what a clean install really refers to. Then reinstall the applications you use. My preference actually is to reinstall them as I need them, so I actually only end up with the applications I truly use. Finally, restore your data. As you go along, as you use your applications, as you want to work on whatever it is you want to work on, get the data, either from the backup image that you created, or perhaps, as is very common, you may have other copies of that data stored elsewhere as well. But that's it. The result of this is actually really cool. It's a clean machine running a clean copy of Windows with everything reinstalled. All of the cruft that may have accumulated over the years will have been removed. And in theory, you'll have a much better running machine. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/3905. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.